In this video, I'm going to take you step by step through my HyperCube build, which will save you a ton of time building your own Infinity Mirror Cube. I'm going to outline the best glass to use, how to frame it, and how to add LED chasing lights like these. I'll even show you how the lighting effects can be controlled from your phone, like this. Hi guys, I'm Krista, mirror geek for 2amirrors.com. A HyperCube works by combining a semi-transparent mirror and a first surface mirror with LED strips in between. The transparent mirror we use is a glass 2A mirror with a tempered top piece to prevent shattering. To further enhance the number of reflections, I used a first surface mirror on the base of the cube. A lot of people ask me, what glass should I use? To make a true HyperCube, your glass should be directional. This is critical to creating that super deep infinity effect with very few reflections coming off of it. This is a standard glass two-way mirror sample, and this is what we recommend for infinity cubes like this. When I show it this way, this is the non-mirror side. So it looks dark. But when you flip it over, you get to see the mirror side. If it's not directional, it will look like this. This is an acrylic two-way mirror sample that we have. It's a mirror on this side, but when you flip it over, it's still a mirror. Ideally, use the real deal. If you're on a budget, you can use a directional two-way mirror film. The film appears more foggy, so you get fewer reflections. For the bottom mirror, I used an acrylic first surface mirror. I used this instead of a standard mirror because the mirror coating is actually on the top, making the HyperCube virtually seamless. What type of LEDs should I use? For the LED light strip, I recommend using a bright one, at least 12 volts. 5-volt strips tend to be way too dim. You'll want an LED strip that supports individually addressable LEDs. This will allow you to truly customize your cube, which is a lot of fun. You could make your own kaleidoscope effects, or maybe a slow meditative trance. Pick your favorite colors and get creative. The controller works hand in hand with the strip, so you'll need one that's compatible and connects to your phone with Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. Don't worry, I'll leave links to the parts in the description below. Now let's talk about the frame. To save time and money, I bought an end table with glass on Amazon for less than $100. Then I added metal strips from Home Depot, which were cut to size using a chop saw. The metal strips support the LED tape, allowing light to be channeled within the table. I chose this table because it's an ultra-thin and sleek design, so thick bars aren't obstructing the view. Here's how it all fits together. Hit that subscribe button right now to stay tuned for my next video, where I go into even more detail on how to put this together. I'm super excited to use mine. Cameraman, where is my Infinity Mirror dress? If you have any questions, leave a comment below or shoot me an email. Until next time, I'm Krista and I'm Audi 5000.